Adobe has shipped a new version of After Effects with exciting multi-frame rendering that significantly speeds up render performance. To complement this release, we are happy to announce that Mocha AE now works seamlessly with MFR and also includes an improved AdjustTrack module to help you nail the most difficult tracking shots. Hi, I'm Mary Poplin. And here I am going to cover the newest version of Mocha AE, which ships free inside Adobe After Effects. To show off the new features, we'll use Mocha to track some graphic flags to this bridge shot, and we'll also use linked planar tracking to drive some animated masks for the final composite. You can find and apply Mocha AE in the Effects menu under Boris FX Mocha AE, or select your layer and find Track in Boris FX Mocha under the Animation window. View your effects controls and click the icon to launch the Mocha interface. Our first goal is to capture the motion of the bridge surface. And since the movement is traveling off screen, we'll use multiple shapes to help us. Typically, we would draw a large shape around the area we want to track, but in this case, the object we want to track is moving off screen and also has a lot of complex pixel patterns. Instead, we'll break up our search area into multiple planes for more control. First, we'll create a rectangle shape and then add a few more small shapes using the Add To button, which is represented by the plus symbol and found on all the spline tools. By selecting Add, we can draw multiple shapes on one Mocha layer and focus on the planar tracking only on the specific areas of the bridge that are on the same plane. Before tracking, we can display our surface tool, which represents our tracking data. We can position the surface corners where we want to place our first flag. Since there is significant camera motion, we will enable all track motion options, including perspective, and then start tracking forwards. When I am tracking something that goes off screen, I like to use this offset tracking technique. We'll stop the track before the area goes off screen, and then create a new shape on the same layer using the Add To spline tool. Then we continue tracking. The new search shapes will keep our track focused on the same planar motion with an offset relationship. We can check the track using the grid overlay. It looks good, but not as perfect as I'd like it to be. Tracking objects that move off screen or that have motion blur can sometimes introduce drifting motion. Mocha AE's new Adjust module is designed to help you finesse and fix tracking your data. Let's switch from the Essentials layout to Classic layout and select the Adjust Track module. Make sure the Quick Windows overlay is visible by selecting this icon or use Alt-8 for a keyboard shortcut. In the Adjust Track module, we'll enable all parameters to match our tracking options and then select Set Points. Now we have four reference points that we can use to evaluate our track and correct drift. Since the top two corners go out of screen quickly, we may position the top reference points a little lower, as long as they are placed on the same general surface. For example, anywhere here will be a good reference point, but we would not want to use an area that is not on the front surface of the bridge. With the reference points set, we can now scrub the timeline and compare each reference with the corresponding frame in the zoom window. We can use the nudge keys controls to move this back in place for each point. The adjusted keyframes will be interpolated across the timeline, resulting in a more accurate surface that sticks without drift or jitter. We can also add new reference points across the timeline. For example, if one of our reference points is no longer useful because it is off-screen, we can add a new point and follow the same editing steps to continue adjusting and fixing our track. If we are happy with our track, we'll exit the Mocha AE interface and save. Back in After Effects, we will focus on the tracking data. We'll select Create Track Data, and Mocha will let us create the tracking data from the selected layer. In this case, we only have one Mocha layer, so we select OK. Now we have our four surface corners and the center point keyframes generated. I want to apply the tracking data to this flag graphic, so first I will make sure the layer is scaled to fit the comp that has been pre-comped. Then, I will select corner pin with motion blur as my export option, and the flag pre-comp as the target. We'll select Apply Export. Now our tracked Mocha data has been applied as a corner pin effect. As I scrub through the comp, note that I have multiple plugins enabled, including a mix of Boris Continuum and Sapphire filters for warping, blur, and grain. Happily, beyond Mocha AE, Continuum, Sapphire, and Mocha Pro plugins all now support MFR for faster rendering. In the render panel here, we can now see how long each effect will take to render. And our preview performance with multiple effects is very interactive. To create some quick masks, let's relaunch the Mocha AE interface. Since we already have tracked the surface of the bridge, we don't have to retrack anything. I'll create a new layer with the X-Spline tool and right-click on the handle to increase the tension of the spline. Then we'll go to the Layer Properties panel and link this layer to our track layer. Note that if you have used the AdjustTrack module, you can use Link to Adjusted and your splines will follow the improved tracking. Now we can scrub through the timeline and make a few small keyframes and we have a tracked mask. To keep this simple, again I'll use the Add to Layer on the X-Spline tool and add a few more masks, and since they are on the same layer, they are already linked to the same track. We will exit and save Mocha AE. In the Effect control, we twirl down the matte parameters and select Visible Layers to choose which Mocha layer we want for masking. We'll select our mask layer and choose Create AE Mask to convert our Mocha splines to native AE splines. I'll copy and paste these splines to a solid layer as a track mat and dial the layer opacity to have our tracked flag graphics sit in the scene. As you might imagine, to add more graphics to the same bridge surface, I can relaunch Mocha AE and simply move my surface to where I want a second flag to be. And again, we can link more shape layers to our original track and add keyframes to follow. And here is the second flag graphic. And again, both graphic layers have multiple Boris FX plugins, all taking advantage of multiple CPUs and processing quickly, thanks to AE's new multi-frame rendering. And that's it. If you are new to Mocha, we are just scratching the surface on how Mocha works with After Effects. We encourage you to check out the new Mocha Essentials video series on the Boris FX website for over 7 hours of free training videos. Visit us at borisfx.com to learn more about the Boris FX suite of visual effects tools and plugins.